government reopen?
Do you have confidence in Secretary Mnuchin?
Yes, I do. Very talented guy, very smart person. They're raising interest rates too fast. That's my opinion, but I certainly have confidence. But I think it'll straighten. They're raising interest rates too fast because they think the economy is so good.
Well, joining me now is Director of U.S. International Institutional Equities and a Global Market Strategist at Jones Trading, Yousef Abbasi. Yousef, good morning.
INTL FCStone is my new firm, just to
correct
that.
Oh, well, now we know.
Yeah, no problem. Just joined a couple months ago, so understand the confusion.
Well, congratulations.
Happy holidays. Glad to be here.
Happy holidays. Do you think there's a loss of confidence in the president, the Treasury Secretary, and or the Fed chair?
Yeah, I think there's dysfunction and discord in Washington, and investors had lost confidence in this market as a whole. You had a situation where they've been whipsawed for 2 months, and so any of these speed bumps along the way seem to create a moment of trepidation or you know, hesitation to enter the market.
Yeah, but why would Steven Mnuchin blast out that he had this call with the major banks? Because if you weren't worried, the fact that he was worried made you worry.
Correct. Absolutely. You know, I think obviously people signal a move like that from Secretary Mnuchin and think, wow, are they that disconnected that they thought there was something going on with the U.S. financial institutions that was that disparate? I think if anything, they probably looked at the way banks were trading and saying, we haven't really seen this since the Eurozone sovereign debt crisis. Maybe that was part of the concern. But there is a disconnect there in the way the administration's viewing things that may have shocked some people.
And what about the disconnect at the Fed?
The disconnect at the Fed is interesting. You have a Fed that has probably the most arduous task in front of it, right?
Yeah.
They have to unwind this balance sheet. They have to deal with an economy that is facing uncertainty on trade. They have to deal with several factors. And so I think the Fed moving forward actually kind of induces confidence, because you think if they did hold in December, you would have said, well, what are they seeing that we don't know?
Yousef, one of the things that Secretary Mnuchin had talked about was high volume trading or robo trading or algorithms, and them, that being the reason why the market sell off is so dramatic. Mm-hmm. And the Wall Street Journal reported overnight that 85% of the trades on the NASDAQ or the New York Stock Exchange are on autopilot. Yeah. So is that really what's causing this sharp decline and volatility to rise as quick as it has?
Yeah, that is definitely a part of it. You've definitely seen market structure shift over the past several years. There is the advent of more sophisticated algorithm trading models and CTA models and risk parity trades. They're targeting different asset classes, they're targeting different structures, right? You're thinking of targeting, instead of returns, you're targeting a risk profile. And now things can kind of go haywire when volatility is elevated for a prolonged period of time after a volatility had been so subdued for a prolonged period of time.
But just to follow up, so what are some of the triggers? If the Fed moves or doesn't move, is that a trigger? Is oil a trigger?
Yeah, I think oil is definitely a trigger that could signal the potential, you know, R word, that recession word. The inversion of the yield curve is another one that may have signaled that. And some of these are spurious relationships at best at this point, right? At this point, this market looks like it's signaling that we're 6 to 8 months out of a start of a recession based on where the multiple is. Mm. And that is simply just not there right now, right?
How much of the selling that we're seeing is the retail investor, the regular person in charge, because all the big money and the institutional guys, they left. They closed out their books already for 2018.
I think there is some panic amongst retail. I think, yeah, some of this might also be tax loss selling into the end of the year.
Uh-huh.
But again, it seems like a lot of it is being driven by algos, and a lot of the smart guys have put their pencils down for the end of the year to take a break and a breather.
But, you know, the safe haven stocks are in jeopardy now. Investors are searching for new investments in 2019 to ride out this turbulence. What would you suggest to those investors?
Looking across this market, looking across asset classes, the one thing that I realize is a lot of these safe haven sectors still haven't really disconnected from a relative multiple to the S&P, so where they generally trade versus the S&P on a multiple basis. Those safe haven assets are holding up pretty well. It's, you know, obviously the risky assets where, you know, people need to, when they calendar turns, I think they'll come back and they'll be more prepared to look at these, and they'll sharpen their pencils and dig into financials and energy and tech. Those are the sectors that right now are trading at multiples relative to the S&P that are well below average.
Are stocks cheap now? Like, should are you missing an opportunity if you don't step in and buy the stock market? I mean, we've come down tremendously.
Yeah, I think stocks are cheap, but I think timing is everything, and I think it may take a turn of a calendar.
Do we go lower? I mean, we're up a little bit now in the pre-market, but do we go lower from here?
I mean, we could. The next few days are
This is the Santa Claus rally week. This week and the first 2 days of January.
There has been no Santa Claus rally is canceled. I think people were whipsawed past G20 and just couldn't get past that.
But not for Main Street. How much Christmas shopping, Dr. Mike, did you do? Main Street, we're looking at record sales.
Yeah, we're seeing exciting sales. Retail, I spent a lot of time in the stores, and that was unexpected. But if you're talking about getting retail stocks in play, is there anything I should be looking for as a young investor trying to invest my money?
Yeah, I think you should consider some of the dynamics that retail has been facing, whether it's shipping costs, whether it's some of the technological upgrades they have to go through, whether it's just the supply chain disruption that's occurring because of trade. So all of those things into 2019 are high on everyone's list, and they create that headwind.
MasterCard Spending Pulse is out with their retail numbers, and they said this year saw the strongest holiday sales increase for U.S. retailers in 6 years. They're putting money on that. This is in-store and online sales. $850 billion this holiday season. So if the consumer's healthy, what is Wall Street so worried about?
Wall Street is incredibly worried about a series of things, and I think one of them is tighter monetary policy. One of them is the outlook on trade. One of them is just the continued uncertainty and dysfunction in Washington. I mean, it'd be great if we came back in January and a conversation was, guys, we've got the shutdown resolved. It looks like things are moving pretty fluidly in Washington. I mean, there are situations and scenarios this market is pricing in that seem to indicate there could be a clawback of the Trump tax cuts. Some of these scenarios that you would think are very far-fetched, these tail risks are being factored into this tape right now.
But if our economy is between 70% consumer driven and the consumer is still confident, that's an underlying fundamental that you can't overlook. So there's clearly a disconnect between the economy and what's going on in the markets.
Yep. Yeah, it's scary as an investor. You have to not only pay attention to what's going on in the markets, but you also have to pay attention to the politics, if not more so, because that speculative effect that you see happen, if something happens in the Trump administration, if something happens internationally abroad, it almost doesn't matter how well the companies are performing. And that's so confusing to someone like me who's trying to get invested into the market for the first time.
I think to your point on the consumer and also to reflect on what you said, you have to also consider home sales have kind of been in a steady decline for 6 months. You have to look at auto sales. They've kind of been relatively flat for the past 2 months. So those things where people would get excited about, those large ticket items seem to be coming in, and I think people see
and
them
as... And they're interest rate sensitive.
They are interest rate sensitive,
exactly.
Both of them.
We just mentioned the shutdown. Mm-hmm. We're in day five. Yep. Normally, historically, shutdowns don't affect the stock market all too much, but both sides digging in their heels. I don't know what it's going to take for a compromise. Do you see the shutdown really affecting portfolios?
Initially, I thought that it wouldn't and shouldn't, but it's just, again, where sentiment is right now. We are not even at glass half full or half empty. We are, like, looking at a, you know, three-quarters full cup of water and saying, this might as well be empty, or we're about to spill it. And that just seems to be the sentiment that we're moving forward with. And it's just, that is why a government shutdown.